So our final speaker, and apologies if I pronounce your name wrong, but is Ika Pradnya Nida? Is that how you say it? Yes.
Yeah, that's right.
With the title Human Cognitive Shifting in AI and Computer Assistant Assisted Material Crafting for Design and Making. Thanks very much.
Okay. Good evening in Indonesia and good afternoon maybe in London. Hi everyone, my name is Igede Eka Pradnya Nida. I'm from Indonesia. And today I'm going to present my paper entitled Human Cognitive Shifting in ER and Computer Assisted Material Crafting for Design and Making. So this is the outline of my presentation today. So basically, this paper will mainly investigate the possibilities of using augmented reality tools to bridge the gap between intuitive human crafting skill and fully automated process for material exploration and making in design. And human capability in design process is relatively slow, weak, lot of error, and lacking of precision. However, they have a good capability to make decision as well as inventing various uniform and ordinary design. While machine can be so precise and also fast, but they are not so adaptive in fast changing and fluctuating process of the fabrication. So by combining AR technology and advanced machine and skills designer, will it enable architect to spontaneously and intuitively interact in a complex design, give live feedback during the design, and bridge the gap between imprecision of the human and high precision of the machine. But the question is, what is possible improvement that can be accomplished by combining virtual and reality into one design environment using AR technology to overall design process, and how far this collaboration can exchange the process of the design, and can it alter human behavior action in design process with then transform the design result and can seek the possibility of a new design language and ability to simplify the fabrication method. And this is the methodology that I set for the research. And I did a role play for the participant, and each participant will do a text based on the scenario that I already made. And it will recorded, and then the recorded video will be analyzed and tag it based on the several criteria like time, action, steps, tool use, and method. And this one is first experiment. And for the manual and AR modeling, for the manual modeling, the results you can see at the beginning of the work, the participant finished the task in the clear and well order step, however, in the midpoint onward, the step started to get out of control and loss of order. It can be seen from the number of error that user made. At the end of the process. Well, in ER modeling was done in a well-ordered step from the beginning until the end of the process. But mostly user only did two action for this process from overall process, like changing direction and the modeling. And this one, as you can see, the result of the manual modeling and the ER modeling. So the AR modeling give a more good result than the manual modeling in the same time, and also give a lot of potential shape than the manual modeling. And this one is for the assembly. For the manual assembly, in the beginning of the work, the participant was able to determine and arrange the component quite well. And with the well-ordered step, however, it took quite a long time to refill and analyze and match the digital and physical component at the beginning of the process, while the AR assisted assembly finished the task quicker than the assembly work without holographic guidelines with 5 minutes difference. So this one is the result of the test. In the left side, you can see the participant cannot finish the model. Cannot finish the model really well. It's almost not half of the model can be finished. And this is the ER assisted assembly. So if the R can help user to finish the work really well and also determine the step really well. And this one is the result for the manual curve bending. So I used two curves for the experiment. So on the manual bending curve, the time spent to finish the work for each curve is slightly different. It's 50 second difference. And the second curve need more time to be done due to the complexity and the amount of the bending points. And the participant did more action in checking the image to guide them to bend the metal bar. So like they need to like see 2 points to the work. While on the AR bending, but curve could be done quicker than the manual bending because the image already overlay with the material. So the user doesn't need to see 2 points to do the work. However, this holographic assisted bending work, the first curve was done faster than the second curve because the complexity of the curve, maybe they need to see the angle. And this is the result. The top one is for the manual bending. The bottom one is for the ER assisted bending. So you can see the different result in this one. And the conclusion is this collaboration could be seen as the new type of blueprint that can help to project real drawing. It can be changed also real time. So despite it has a problem in the deep of field, so that makes scale in reality different from the virtual world, it will make the user hard to define and extract the starting point to put the overlay the physical material into the holographic images. However, this kind of technical problem is minor things that can be resolved by altering the coordinates in the computer or using any like pegging or ER code to determine the position, first position. This also can be considered as a new type of the model in both digital and physical, with user can experiment with the real material in virtual and also help human to reveal a lot of potential in material character, new shape, and the possibility of the new design language. The shifting habit also appear to be a positive sign to the to the result that allow user to simplify the process and create more unique design. And that's all for me, from me, and thank you.